I welcome you to this session of ISO 9001:2015, and today we are going to talk about clause number 8.5.6, control of changes. So as usual, first of all I'll read out the requirement to you as given in the standard. The organization shall review and control changes for production or service provision to the extent necessary to ensure continuing conformity with the requirements. The organization shall retain documented information describing the results of the review of changes, the persons authorizing the change, and any necessary actions arising from the review. So this is all. This is a small clause. This is the total requirement as given in clause number 8.5.6, control of changes. So let us discuss it in more detail. See, there could be a requirement for making changes while we are producing the product or we are providing the service. The organization may consider it essential or necessary to make some changes to the documentation or drawings or whatever is felt necessary, so that the ultimate requirements which the organization has committed to the customer, they are fulfilled. So in case of any changes, the changes have got to be made in a controlled manner. That is the basic crux of this requirement. Now, I'll read the first para. The organization shall review and control the changes. So, before any change is made, either a change to the drawing or a change to the procedure or method of production or any safety aspect or anything, the organization will definitely have to review the change before the change is made into the documents. So the review is very essential, and without review nothing should be changed. So that is part of the control mechanism, that whatever review we are making, whatever changes we are making, that change is reviewed, and the change is made by the authorized people. Everybody cannot make changes. So the request for change may be made by anyone, but whether change should be made or not, only the authorized personnel can consider the change, and they will have to carry out a review of change, get the final approval done, and then only make the changes in the documentation or drawings or whatever is required. And this has to be done in a controlled manner. That means each and every copy of that document has got to be replaced with the new one, and the new document has got to be duly approved and signed by competent authority, and then the person responsible has to ensure that this new copy, changed copy, reaches everyone, whosoever is involved in the production or service provision, that copy must go to that person. So that is the controlled manner in which the document distribution is carried out. And it is to be done to the extent necessary to ensure continuing the conformity with the requirement. See, the whole purpose is that if we are making any changes, the changes should be made so that the product or the service continues to meet the requirement that was agreed to in the contract, requirement which was agreed to with the customer. So it should be meeting, and that continuation of conformity has got to be maintained by the organization. And for all doing all these things, the organization has to retain documented information. That means proper records have to be maintained with regard to what changes, who initiated the change, who approved the change, how the changes were reviewed, the review record, and then the changes made, and finally the distribution of the revised documentation. Everything, the entire record must be available. So that is how the requirement of this clause will be fulfilled. So we are supposed to maintain records of all changes made. So, and the results of review, they are also to be included in the records. The persons authorizing the change and any necessary actions arising from the review. So all this has got to be put on record. So the proper records have got to be maintained. This is a very small clause, and I hope there is nothing which you have not been able to understand in this clause. And if there is anything by chance where you have a doubt, please put your comments below this video and I will make it clear to you. And please do not forget to subscribe to my channel and also press the bell icon so that the next video that I load, the information regarding that will reach you without any delay. And if you are liking my videos, please give me a thumbs up, give me a like, and also share my videos with your friends and colleagues. I'll feel very happy if you do so. Thank you all very much for watching my videos, and bye, and see you next week again. Bye bye.